If you have doubt, we can do it. Okay. So business organizations is a topic today, and we have the show, PowerPoint show organized this way. It has the understanding of business as well as business organizations. So let us see the definition of a business. You have three varieties, and you can give your own way of looking at business. But at the end, business is something which gives you money, which you name it as profit or income, whatever. Okay, for someone it is income, for someone which is profit, which is the net of all kinds of expenses. Okay, then types of business: direct business, indirect business. Direct business means where you are doing business directly on your name. Let it be in any form on your name. It can be in primary sector, secondary sector, or tertiary sector. I gave few examples in that areas. India's GDP is more from tertiary sector, okay, and dominated by IT, software services kind of thing. With telecom services, banking services, and so on. Then indirect services, indirect business could be trading, e-commerce, and investments. Why I'm saying that investments is not business, please don't misunderstand here. There are some companies which make investments for others, not for themselves, like mutual funds, stockholding companies, venture capital companies, private equity firms. They give services by investing for others, and they make money out of it. Okay. For example, Reliance Nippon is one asset management company, which is a mutual fund, and it makes money out of its annual asset management charges or portfolio management charges every year. Similarly, trading and e-commerce. Okay. Then, based on the size of the business, can say the company or the entity is a local company, regional company, national company, or you can also call it as pan India in Indian context. It is an international company because it has foreign sales through exports, it foreign purchases through imports. Okay, the multinational, it is a company which has its own subsidiary with full-fledged. Like I think Vasupratha said, PepsiCo has its operations in India, and she named Indian operations head in an Indian CFO kind of thing. So multinationals have their presence in many countries with complete corporate status, following the rules and regulations of the respective company. And the global company is a company which is there in almost every country: Coca-Cola, Pepsi. Okay, what else? Nike, Reebok, apparel brands, food brands, electronic products like laptops, smartphones, iPhones, Sony. There are many global brands which you can try to know what they are exactly. So the biggest in size, we can call it as global, and local is company which is limited to your own village or your own city, your own town, your own area. Okay, we can call it as local company. Like a CMR, we have it loves to operate only in Andhra and Telangana. It will not go beyond that. Okay, doesn't try to operate in Bangalore or Chennai, not even in South India. Forget about Pan India. So those kind of companies, you can call it as local companies. Then, based on business ownership, who owns the business, you can call them as public sector companies, private sector companies, joint sector companies, and even societies. Societies also do business, okay? I think, what is that? Which dairy is running AP Dairy right now? What is that? Amul? Any idea? It is a form of a society. Joint sector is a combination of a private sector and public sector. Most of the public sector, they are government is going for disinvestment. When they go for disinvestment, they either invite public or some private companies into it. Many ports are getting invited with private participation. Okay, to some extent, they try to operate jointly. Maruti Udyog Limited has a joint venture with Suzuki Corporation earlier, but now Maruti Udyog Limited has given its majority of the stake to Suzuki Corporation Japan. It's almost like a joint sector, public private sector together. It's not pure public. Private sector is completely managed by private people or non-government people. Public sector, you take banks, steel plants, cement companies, telecom companies, or nuclear power projects, which are owned by central governments or state governments, mostly central government we refer to, you call it as public sector company. Okay. Now, let us be very clear about business organization. I think you had principles of management in your first semester and would have learned about organization structure of a business. So you should know what is an organization, what is a business organization. Okay. A business organization is organized to have commercial activities with an objective to make money. That's a prime idea. Okay, but there are some organizations, like I told you about societies or government-owned companies like development banks, government-owned infrastructural development companies, where they don't look for profits. Their objective is to provide development in the rural sector, provide employment, provide infrastructure kind of objectives are the criteria, but not profits. But still, they run in a business model. That's the difference. Business organization. Then, now this is the idea for the day. Types of business organizations. Let us see what exactly they are. You can see here. I put it as for-profit organizations, not for profit organizations. For-profit organization, this is the thing which you have to understand. For-profit organizations, where you may have organizations or firms run by individuals. Classic examples or popular examples are sole proprietorship. That's what Deepika was asking me about. And private partnership. Okay. And beyond an individual form of organization, you have private companies. You have one person company, limited liability partnerships, LLPs, and private limited companies. Then something bigger than that, you have a public company, a joint stock company, where you have public limited company and listed company. We'll discuss in detail. Okay. Then in non-profit organizations, you have government organizations, which are not meant for profit at all. And NGOs, there are many NGOs you might be experiencing in these pandemic times, helping with the food service or medical supplies, transportation services, and so on. They operate in the form of a trust or society and cooperatives. In many colleges, many educational institutions, many healthcare organizations, they operate through NGOs. Okay. So societies can also run for profit, not for profit. I wish I'm clear. And there are other things to discuss in detail. I'll show you. Let us talk about individual firms. Okay. So you can see them. I already told you there are two, sole proprietary or partnership, run only by individuals, male or female, old or young, but they should not be minors. They should be majors. There is a one has to follow the guidelines for that. So there is no difference between individual's income and business income. Both are same. And again, taxation, personal income tax and business income tax, both are same. And one more thing is, if person dies, business dies. If person is alive, business is alive. So that's how the individual firms go, sole proprietary and partnership. And let us go more into sole proprietary. It is the oldest form. Not only that, it is big in number across the world, not only in India, across the world. More retail businesses are run in sole proprietary form than most of the popular entities. They started as, of course, we have the trend of startups now. But earlier, most of the big brands, they started as sole proprietary only. Then they may have trade name or brand name. It is their choice. Then one person is running one business does not mean he or she should run only one business. No, you can run n number of businesses on different names, but still you are the owner. You are the sole proprietor. You can do that. Okay. Can you hear me, guys?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay, good. Thank you. There are minimum requirements. You can check in the MSME's website in India and how the banking has to be done, online transactions can be done, funding to be done, what are your plans to grow. There are more helping hands in MSME. And more about this, it's also known as sole trader, individual entrepreneurship, proprietorship, and privately held. Okay. So, any questions on sole proprietary? You can ask me. And advantages. Easy to start. Less legal framework. No corporate income taxes, only personal income tax. And the major disadvantages are limited life. Person dies, business dies. Person is alive, business is alive. Liability is unlimited. If a person defaults on business loans, then the banks or the financial institutions who have lended the money, they can claim on your personal assets like home, car, gold, diamonds, jewelry, land, apartment, TV, refrigerator, anything. Anything which is there on your name, in your possession. And the other disadvantage is if you want to grow every year and you need money, it's difficult to raise capital. Banks will not come forward. It is a sole proprietary. That is the biggest disadvantage. Then let us talk about partnership. I'm just going on. If you have any question, please stop me and ask me. Do not mind. So this is just similar to a sole proprietary, but the difference is it is one person. You know, we have more than one person. It could be 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. There's no limit on that. It could be up to you. So why people look for partnership is, I think, in disadvantage or advantage, I will show you that. I can see you there. Where is that? Okay, let us go one by one then. Then there are some partnership acts binding the business to follow. There should be minimum numbers and maximum is 100. You can also, I forgot to tell you, in sole proprietary, if you want to transform, yes, you can convert that into OPC. Similarly, in partnership, this can be converted into LLP or PLC, and even other companies' forms you provided, you suffice all the requirements. And if each partner has its own share, then his or her share can be transferred. But all rest of the partner should give the consent. That is the condition here. Then without consent of the partners, a person is partners can assign share to a person to receive all financial benefits. Financial benefits is different from share transfer. Then if what if someone wants to close the partnership firm, then if it is small, it is okay. Then if it is big, this becomes complicated. Okay, I gave, if the firm has only two partners, even if one of them dies or passes away, then the company becomes insolvent. Then now in this new economic reforms, we have some legislations closely monitoring and guiding partnership firms to develop, promote development in business. One is unregistered and other one is registered. So this is registered with whom? Registrar of firms. You can find them in MSME's website, or if you type registrar of firms, you can get the information. And when these guys form partnership organization, they will have something called partnership deed. What is that? It has clear details, in short, of firm details, partners, capital, profits, and tenure. Everything is stated here. This is the one which guides the whole company forward and binds all the partners together so that there are no hits generated. If you want to create a partnership firm, the process is given here. So you have to start with the partnership deed first, then register it with stamp duty. That depends on the value, then notarize it. There is something called a notary. You may not be aware of it. You can find it out with a lawyer nearer to you, which is governed by Indian Partnership Act, and it is mandated to get it registered with registrar of firms. If you want a deed, okay, then take a PAN for the firm. Like individual PANs we have, we also have PAN for partnership firm. Okay, then some of the examples, why I gave you this example is, it's not that I think it applies to sole proprietary also. Size of the business usually dictated by form of organization. If it is partnership, sole proprietary is small, partnership little better, private limited bigger, public limited much bigger, listed is very big. It may happen usually, but that is, there is no rule like that. Even partnership or private sole proprietary firm can be much bigger. There is a company called Cargill, which is much bigger, started by the person named Cargill, initially a sole proprietary, then later it got converted into a partnership where his own family members became partners of this company. You can find more of such kind of examples. Okay, so that is about individual firms owned by individuals. Then private companies, how many I told you, private companies, you remember? How many? Oh God.
Three,
the
sir.
Beginning only. Sorry.
Three, sir.
What are they?
One-person company. One-person company, limited liability partnership, and private limited company.
Very good. Very good. Thank you. So I was talking about those three. These are the, this is what we have. one person company, LLP, and PLC, private limited company. In general, for all these three, this is what it happens. A registrar of for private firms, proprietorship or partnership, registrar of firms is more important. But when it comes to private company, even public limited companies also, it is registrar of companies and Ministry of Corporate Affairs. This comes into the picture. So why people go for private limited companies like OPC, LLP or PLC? The reason is, let us see the advantages. Unlimited life. Even the persons die, the company remains live. Okay. Then limited liability. If the company defaults, the lenders will claim on the assets of the company or organization. It's not, they don't touch whatever is there on the owner's name. And once you are a private limited or OPC or LLP, people will believe you. It is easy to raise capital. You can go for funding. And before that, you can attract clients, new clients, big clients, foreign clients. It is easy. If you have a suffix like LLP, PLC kind of thing, or OPC at least, you will be good in doing that. Then raise loans from corporate banking. Yeah, you can start corporate banking and you can, it is very easy. You can get into, I'm not saying that everyone should borrow, but it is easy if you need funds. And the major disadvantage is double taxation. Say, for example, you started one person company. You are doing business well. Okay. Then in this case, what happens is whatever the profits you earn on the name of the company, that attracts corporate tax, number one. Number two is, as an owner, when you receive these profits, this also becomes your income. So this you have to show in your personal income tax also. That is the biggest disadvantage in OPC or any other PLC, LLP or PLC. That's what you called as double taxation. Then cost of setting up and report filing, there is no much cost. If sole proprietary will cost you some, almost sole proprietary doesn't cost you anything. This may cost you some 5,000, 10,000, that's it. It's not a big deal. Then, though OPC, of course, lack of professional management, this is, you will get a good and focused management compared to sole proprietary and partnership. But lack of professional management compared to public limited and private limited companies which are bigger than this. Then the other disadvantage is no separation of ownership and management. Okay. So it is very difficult to understand. Let us see one by one. Things will be clear. Let us see OPC first. I wish you have already gone through this, but still I'm showing you this. Okay. Just go through it quickly, please. Major features I've given you here. You can check the details later also. Okay. I'm just running so that if you have any questions, you can ask me. In case of a sole proprietary or partnership, you don't require any one of these things. But in the case of OPC, you need to have a minimum of 1 lakh and a maximum of 50 lakh rupees as paid up capital. Then you should have unique name registered with MCA. Then PAN is required for a partnership firm also. Then TAN is also required. DIN is required. Okay, because you'll be having directors in this. You are the director. Owner is the director. Then digital signature certificate for all online transactions, reporting and submissions. Then, yeah, when you say, for example, Unlimited Fashion is one company. If you're an OPC, it is mandatory that Unlimited Fashion OPC unit mention that. Similarly, give an example, Indian Garments, in brackets OPC. You need to maintain, you should for sure mention this. These are mandatory requirements. In process, get form INC 30D. This is very, very easy. You can check MCA or Register of Company portal, you will get this. Then submit MOA, AOA, MCA, ROC. Even these things are done. See, my dear students, please understand, I spent several days last year and prepared only for the students so that you can understand. This is the one place, if you want to start a company, you have to follow this. This is very easy. And of course, MCA, ROC websites will also help you. MSME websites also will help you. Then if you want to convert OPC into a PLC or something, those guidelines are also there based on times, requirements, then nominee. You can go through at your leisure time. Then two types of conversions are possible with OPC. One is voluntary conversion. The other one is mandatory conversion. You can check out the details. So advantages, you get a brand, full control because you're only one. You can separate business and business property to personal property. Yeah, efficiency can be seen because you got the brand, some submissions are all are there. Then single existence, you have a legal status, limited life. This is a major advantage. Legal liability is there, limited liability. Then you can have a nominee. If someone passes, leaves the body and goes to the heavenly places, his or her own wife or husband or spouse or kids or parents, anyone can be the nominee. Then profits is to one person. Then you can make a decision, unlike a partnership firm or private limited companies or public limited companies. Yes or no, you can take it. And taxes can be saved. There is, I think I explained there. That's what I mean. Okay. So when you show your own yourself as a employee of the company, then that will be part of this expenses of the company. So your own personal expenditure can be shown as the expenses of the company itself. So that way you can save a lot of taxes also. That's what I meant there. That is OPC. And disadvantages, 50 lakhs, I think I told you, is the limited capital. You cannot go beyond that. You need to convert. Okay. Then it cannot be divided. There is only one share. It is worth of 1 lakh, means only 1 lakh owned by you. It is one man show. Tax rate is higher as of now. 30% is the flat tax rate. And ESOPs cannot be issued. Though you yourself show as an employee, you cannot show as ESOPs. Then compared to sole proprietary and OPC, this is very much detailed. Loads of information, point by point, is given to you. Okay, this is a comparison of sole proprietary and OPC. I think this is a very detailed answer for Deepika's question. What's the difference between sole proprietary and OPC? If you have any question, you can ask me. No question, then I'll go ahead. Some examples I gave you here, OPCs. You can also do a search. Broom Bikes, Fashtoon Apparel, Sneh Sanskriti, Vimoku, Wow Wash. The products also I gave. You can check out more and let me know, share in the group if you have. These are the bright examples of OPCs who hated to be sole proprietary and started as OPCs, and they're successful. That's what our finance minister wants. Our minister wants more OPCs to boom in business. Then LLP is an extension of partnership. Earlier it was not there. It was there, started in 2008. Now it has become most preferred business organization. I'll show you why in the advantages. It is in UAE, in US, in Europe, it is more popular as LLC. We call it as LLP, Limited Liability Partnership. Okay. So it is a mix of limited liability firm and partnership. And some more explanation is given. You can go through it. Self-explanatory. On nature also, you can do it. My point is, you can read about the act. If you want more details, in MSME website or MCA website or Register of Companies website, in detail it is given. But what I did is, I highlighted the major points and cut it down to save your time. You can go through it at your free time. Continued there. Okay. Again, if it wants to convert or change, the details are very clearly given here. This, please understand, my dear student friends, this is for your awareness. Okay. Don't get into syllabus, marks, or that kind of view. This is for your insights into the organization forms. Okay. Then major benefits of LLP. So most of the startups are finding this idea of organization, because startups are getting started by two or more people than one. Of course, there are many which are with a single person. Single person OPC will do. When there are more persons, yeah, LLP is getting the attention. Some details I gave you, you can go through it. Disadvantages. Same, though there are more than one person as owners, ESOPs, employee stock options, are not possible. Tax rate is high, like OPC. Then again, filing documents, reporting, there are some costs involved in this. There is no director designation, but managing partner is used. There are no shares issued. There is no divisibility in OPC, and here, though there is a divisibility attention or scope, no, there are no shares or transferability. Okay. The ownership is divided. Some advantage, sorry, some comparison between, this is important why people look at partnership but not LLP. Why people look at LLP but not partnership. So business and owners are separate. Which one would you like, partnership or LLP, for the first point? Separated or integrated?
Separate, sir. LLP.
Separate, because liability becomes limited. The second yes. point says that. Yeah. Third point, yeah, personal income tax and private company tax, that is 30%, which I already told you. Then personal framework, corporate framework. You have a corporate style, brand, this, that, and so on. And low cost to start, that is the biggest advantage in partnership. But in LLP, you need to shell out at least 10,000. Maybe in future, it may increase. As of now, this is what you may have to spend. I think here, I mentioned something about this. Yeah. Dividend distribution tax is not applied in both the cases because there are no shares, individual shares. Compliance is low in partnership, and here it is little compliance. Then private limited companies. There are many private limited companies. Okay. There are many private limited companies. Okay. So let us see what is a private limited company. So to be precise, it is also perpetual, it doesn't die. It is mandatory to audit, and turnover if it crosses 1 crore. Okay, maybe some details I give you here itself. Okay. Minimum capital is 1 lakh, like I told you about OPC, but there you have a limit of 50 lakhs. But here it can cross 50 lakhs. But you have to submit audit if it is more than something. Okay. Then, so if you want to do FDI, you should be a PLC. That is one thing people are interested in. PLC. It can be converted into public limited company also later. Okay. Shares of independent owners of the company or shareholders are transferable. Okay. And yeah, these are the very few important details. You can check out the website for more details of a PLC or private limited company. So I guess some highlights of a partnership firm and a company or PLC. In the case of partnership, it is limited. Here it is unlimited. In the case of liability, unlimited, limited, profit flow to the pockets of independent owners. Here it may go directly to the owners or it can be reinvested for business growth. Then individual taxation, but here corporate taxation 30%, and double taxation is also disadvantage in the case of PLC. Then liquidity is low. In a partnership, it is high. Funding is low, high here. Governance is low, high here. Then the real thing, public limited company. You find all the companies which are listed in public limited, Bombay Stock Exchange and National Stock Exchange, all of them are public limited companies. There are close to 5,000 companies. All are public limited companies. But there are companies which are not listed. They are still public limited companies. So I think they are more in number. If you take Indian Airlines right now, it is a public limited company. It is not listed. Okay. If you take LG Polymers, which is operating in Vizag, which has methane gas leak. Which gas is that? Not methane. It is a public limited company. It is not listed in NSE or BSE. It is a Korean company. There is no difference between company or corporation. It is the usage. In US or Europe, they use the word corporation. In India, they have company. Okay, but interchangeably, they are used. So the major advantage is you can become branded, nationally branded and internationally branded and globally branded if it is a company. Okay. In addition to that, it is unlimited life, limited liability, easy to raise capital, easy to transfer the ownership. And I think these are similar to OPC, LLP also. Now, unlisted company, listed company, multinational company. So in terms of size, all these are public limited companies only. If you take Reliance, it is a kind of Indian MNC. It is listed, it is public limited. I just gave you some kind of idea. But you also have companies which are public limited but not listed. Okay? That's what I was talking about, that all the publicly limited companies need not be listed. That's my idea of sharing this. This is again about public limited. Then here, registrar of companies, internal governance, board of directors. That's more important. With Satyan Computers, things happened in the board of directors, only some of the directors. One was, I think, Dean, Indian School of Business. He was a director of that. He raised some issues. He got some problems, you know. Board of directors is a big body for a public limited company in terms of governance. Board of directors stands between the company's managers and the shareholders. There are many to see. respective. My time is up. What's the time now? I can't see the time.
2:48, sir.
Yeah, I'm crossing my limits. So quickly, listed companies which are listed in stock exchanges in India, like BSE and NSE. So I think that's it. So I just summarized also. This is quite interesting. You can see them. I gave you everything: sole proprietary partnership, OPC, LLP, PLC, public limited, and listed. Okay. So you can go through them. So this is what I wanted to share with you. This I already told you. So if you have any question, forms of business or business organizations, you can ask me now.
Sir, I have a doubt, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, you have mentioned that we can convert private limited company into public limited company. Likewise, can we convert 1-person company into public limited company?
No, it's not possible. You can convert a 1-person company to private limited company. There are chances. OPC to LLP, LLP to OPC is possible. But OPC to public limited, no, it is not allowed.
But converting by OPC nunchi private limited company convert cheskune tarvata private limited company nunchi public limited company convert cheskochu kada sir?
Cheskochu. But your question is OPC to public limited, right?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, see, I'm traveling to USA from Vizag to New York. There is no direct flight. Vizag to Dubai, Dubai to New York. Okay? So your question is, sir, why can't I fly from Vizag to New York directly? So straight away the answer is no, but you can travel to New York. Vizag to Delhi or Mumbai, and or via Vizag to Dubai, Dubai to New York. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Any other question quickly? Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, any questions still you can ask me. If you are not comfortable asking here, you can put me in the WhatsApp. You can ask me in the slide share. You can call me also, no problem. Anytime I'm available to there.